mostly the Amherst family, and especially Justin and Andrew, but I've met everyone. And I think today I'm especially happy to be here because I get to hear the historical loving friends and family. And I have to say that I grew up with a family that was displaced as well. As my mother was from Idaho, my father was from Indiana, and it's not easy to be displaced.
And then you were in New Jersey.
And then I grew up in New Jersey, so I'm a little displaced myself. And anyway, I'm amazed, and I've been also embraced by Joseph and her family, and I'm here today, and I'm so grateful to be in this circle of loving people who kept that family connection going. And I've got to say, I think you said that your mother had a message to stay together and to work and be together and be family. And we have so little of that these days. With, you know, forget Facebook. I'd rather be human faces and touch each other. So that's what I'm taking away from my contact with this family. And hooray, let's keep it going, right? We have to keep in touch. And I think Gladys, I didn't ever know Gladys when she was speaking, really. But I have to say that being around, if Joseph came in and said, oh, your brother, something, she would always light up. And it's hard. My father had dementia and died actually just a few hours after Nani died, the last day of summer. And it's hard, but you know, when your loved one stops speaking and can't express himself, but you always feel the love, and there's the connection's always there, even after they leave us. So I think it's important to remember that, and I'm so glad for this beautiful memorial service. Anyway, thank you.
Going. It's just been wonderful. May we all keep in touch.
Very good.